1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everybody, come on, let's go and drive. Hey, guys and girls, welcome to another episode of The Angler Call of the Wild. Now, some people are a little bit concerned that if you buy the regular, ordinary, normal version of The Angler Call of the Wild, you only get one map. It's a spectacular looking map. I mean, look at those mountains, look at that lake, look at the flowers, the trees. It's gorgeous. But what we're going to do today in this video is we're going to see how long it takes for me to get one side of this beautiful map, driving like an absolute crazy person, to the other side of the map, or even if that's entirely at all possible. Now, I'm going to do my best not to look at the map, but I'll show you the map. This is where we are here on one side, and we're going to drive all the way over to this side over here. Now, is it as far as the map goes? No, but I do have a couple of undisclosed locations on that side of the map I'd like to go and see. So, what we're going to do is we're going to start out here, and we're going to drive all the way through to here without me looking at the map. Okay? We're going to see if it's possible. You know, are we going to drive the Jeep off a cliff and die? Are we going to drive through a river and drown? Who knows? But I'm going to try and get from here to there without looking at the map, and just so you guys can see how big the map is. Now remember, if you buy the entry-level version of The Angler Call of the Wild, you only get this map, Golden Ridge Reserve. If you buy the premium edition, not only do you get this map, but you get a Norwegian map as well, which I haven't even thought about looking at yet, because I still haven't discovered everything on this map, and I'm at level like 16 or something now, and I still haven't discovered everything. So this is kind of like trying to alleviate your concern that one map's kind of boring, I'm going to have it done in no time. Yet no. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to get in the car, we're going to go for a drive, and we're going to go to that location right here, and we're going to see how long it actually takes for me to drive without using the map. We'll see if I even end up anywhere near close to where I want to go. Let's see how we go. Okay, so first of all, we're going to go get our motor vehicle. Oh, hang on, I've got to pick up something over here. This adds XP, so we'll do that while we're here. XP. I don't know if I get cash for it, but it definitely adds XP. We're going to hire ourselves a Jeep. Here's our Jeep. It's got Cascadia State of the Wild. Okay, cool. Number plate there. All right, let's get in. Now, the only thing I dislike about this at the moment is our video views is literally behind the dials on top of the base of the windscreen, or on top of the top of the windscreen, or on the hood. That's it. There's no third person view. So unfortunately, if you suffer from motion sickness, this video might give you a little bit. So just have some you know, pause the video if you need to, just chill and kind of relax. You know, remember, this is a video game. You can just listen to the sound of my voice or listen to the audio if you think you're going to get a little bit sick. But anyway, we're going to head off right now. Let's go. Now, I think where I need to go is behind me. So we're going to go this way. I could be totally wrong. Remember, not looking at the map. And I think I might be heading the wrong direction. Just a hunch. Alright. So we're going to go crossroads up ahead. I'm gonna head this way. Oops, straight through there. Yep, no worries. Now, you'll hear a lot of ambient noises as you're driving through, because I don't know if they've added any animals or anything yet, or even if they're going to, but the sounds of animals like sheep, roosters, wolves, whatever, they're here. You just don't get to see them. Okay. Now, unfortunately, the music is going to be with us until I get a fair way out of town. Okay, and we're gonna keep going. 40 miles an hour, 40 kilometers. I'm not real sure, but I'm driving really quickly now. And ta-da! Lovely big lake there. 7.7 kilometers to go, so I've only done 300 meters in this space of time. And we've traveled a fair distance away from where we're supposed to be. That's a tree. Now, at the moment, the Jeep doesn't have a damage fix. At the moment, it doesn't. Which is a good thing. Right? I'm sure they're going to bring it in at some point, but at the moment, no damage fix. And I mean, it's just spectacular. Look at it. And I mean, we're using a Jeep. We've rented a Jeep. But there's nothing stopping us from renting a boat and using a boat. Now, I'm not sure if I have to use that walking trail. As you can see, it's a walking trail, not a driving trail. Or whether I should stick to the main road. I'll stick to the main road for now. And if I feel like it's taking me in the wrong direction, I'll probably take a walking path or two to get there. I feel like this is going in the wrong direction. But we'll see. Maybe it'll curve around and take me back to where I need to go. I don't know. Okay, I'm going to go this way. I'm definitely not going to go over there. Sorry. 35 at night. That's a wise thing. At night this place gets pretty dark. You're driving by headlights. You don't get to see very much in front of you. Now, Clayton is the owner or the warden of this park, and I'm pretty sure Clayton would be pretty angry that I'm driving at a little bit more than he's supposed to speed limit. It's a little bit too much. Oh boy. Here we go, this Jeep might not actually make it up to you, but we'll see. Come on, you can do it. There we go. Falling rocks, lovely. Okay, we've come to a lake. I'm just going to take a shortcut. Don't mind me. Oh, there we go. Shortcut. Not really. Now, I could go over here, hire a boat, drive down the river, find myself another Jeep rental agency, and get in, but we won't do that. So we'll take 10 seconds off our time for that detour. 10 seconds. Sounds fair to me. Might have only been 5, but I'm going to take 10. Now, we've been driving at this point in time for 5 minutes. Pretty much a solid 5 minutes, and we've only done less than a kilometer. So I'm thinking you guys are getting a hint to how big this map really is. It's quite large. Quite huge. It says slow, but I'm just going to nail it. What's the worst that can happen? Look, that would be the worst that can happen. I hit a sign and bounce off. Yes, I just jumped onto the bridge and it bounced up a little bit. Now, I don't know whether you guys can hear it, but there's a roar of a massive, big waterfall just off to my left. There it is. The waterfalls in this game are really quite spectacular, but we don't have time to stop and worry about that. It's like trying not to put us into a ditch. Okay, we're gonna go this way. Now, when you first start out this game, you will be spending a lot of your time looking for the outpost, much like you did with Hunter Call of the Wild. Looking for your outposts, the ones that are on top of mountains and all that. So you will spend a lot of your time exploring. It says stop. Yeah, right. I don't think there's any other traffic. I think we're good to go here. But you will spend a lot of your time exploring. Now, this game does encourage you to walk, but if you drive like I am, you will miss a majority of the things that the warden wants you to find. So be aware of that. If you do take the jig path like I am doing, you can miss certain aspects of what you're supposed to do for missions. Just be aware of that. Go down here. Oh, here we go. Whee! Donk. Now, it is just a spectacular game just to drive through. You know, you can take your time, you can slow down, you don't have to be as quick as me. You can see the sights, have the lights, and see every foreign shore. Ah, I need the brake. Yeah, I don't think I'm on that way. We're gonna go this way. Nope, that's the sign there. Now, have I made the right decision in going this way? I've got no idea. For all I know, I could be doing a complete loop. No clue. But this map is huge. Oop, that's a tree. Now, I'm driving on keyboard. Main reason why I'm driving with the keyboard today and not the controller is my fingers need a bit of exercise today. And not only that, I just feel more comfortable, you know, driving with the keyboard in this game. The other day I said you probably need a controller. Well, turns out my controller was not an Xbox controller, but a Switch controller, which resulted in me hitting a lot of buttons the wrong way, and in the end I just got annoyed. I don't even see where the road goes. Okay, let's hope I don't drop us off into that river down there. Oh boy. Nah! I'll drive over here. Seems safe. Now, we've been cruising now for just on 9 minutes, and I'm nowhere near my target. Maybe I should go this way. Bit off-roading, never hurt anyone. Whoa. Oh boy. Thank goodness for all that practice on spin tires, or we were. Oh boy. I was going to say thank goodness for all that practice I have on spin tires, because I'm too handy with driving these things off-road. Yeah, you know what? I'm good. That was kind of scary. Didn't expect that to happen, but it did. I think this is a walking trail, and I'm driving a Jeep down it. Yeah, I don't think this was meant for a car. Oop. Well, Lucky we don't have collision damage, else that could have cost me. Okay. So I have gone off-road a little bit, but I'm still not using the map. And yes, this was definitely a walking trail. That's a bridge. Okie doke. Alright. Part of me wants to go that way through the mountain and down, but I think I'm going to head this way. It feels like a safer bet, I think. I don't know. I'm not looking at the map. Well, no map navigation challenge. It does feel like I'm heading back the way I came, even though it feels like I've been further over. I don't know. Now, I think if I take that road here, it's just going to put me up on top of the mountain. Up there, so I don't want to go that way. Look, a fjord. Even though it says Ford, it's a fjord. F-J-O-R-D. They just have F-O-R-D. Okay. So, just coming up to the 16-minute mark at the moment, and I'm still 5.4 kilometers away. Okay, through the fjord. Oh, don't drown it. I don't have snorkels. Ah. Now, I'm going to go that way. Cross the bridge. Back around the corner. Oh, don't drown me. Slow. Yeah, no, we're definitely not doing that. We're not doing it slow. I'm hoping this is going to turn at some point to the right and lead me to my destination. Oh boy, no rock crawling. This is not an RC video. Sorry. Now, if you guys want to see me do a boat navigation challenge, where I start at the furthest lake, and see if I can get to the other side of the map without using a jeep, we could also try that. I don't know how successful we go, because I don't know whether I can launch boats off waterfalls or not, or even if I can get anywhere near close to the waterfalls with a boat. But we could try that, I suppose. If you guys give this enough thumbs up, we could try that. And also, comment down below if you want to see that. And I'm going to test who actually watches all my videos by saying, if you've watched all this so far, post down in the comment section the word potato, just so I know. Just the word potato, that's it. Okay, we're at the Diamond Peak Outlet outpost now. This is not the same one as we drove into. So, what we're going to do is be fair to the jeep. We're going to get out. We're going to quickly run across to here. We're going to hire another one. And we'll go the Blue Rat Voyage. It doesn't really matter. It's just a different skin. And I do see it's got a little four-wheel drive button on the side of the automatic transmission there, so that's quite cool. We didn't take any time doing that. Okay, we'll keep going, keep cruising. This needs to take a drastic turn to the right if I'm to get to where I need to go. So I'm going to be looking at opportunities to turn to the right whenever they pop up. Will that result in dead ends? I don't know. Now, as you can see, I'm driving at a fairly rapid pace. I'm not dawdling. Keeping the hammer down wherever possible. And as you can see, it's taken quite some time. You know, it's taken a fair while. So, as I said, those who are worried about this being a one-map game, you've got nothing to worry about. Airborne! Is that a trail? Can I go down there? No. We're gonna go this way. Come on, let's go. Watch out for Buffalo? I haven't seen him. I hope they bring them in. It's just randomly roaming objects that don't actually interfere with you. That would be cool. Go this way. I really hope I don't end up back where I started, because that would be a fail and a half. Well, it seems to be going in the right direction. I am getting closer. We're gonna go that way. It feels correct. I don't know if it is correct, but it feels like we're heading in the right direction. I don't know. I'm not looking at the map, remember? No map navigation challenge. Of course I'm using a navigation point. That's how I know where I'm going to go. But, oh boy. Oh, the trail keeps going. This might be okay, or this could end in tragedy with me falling off a cliff to my doom. But here we go, coming up the hill, running out of power, drop it down a gear. We're going to keep going straight, I think. Go this way. Oh, maybe I made the wrong decision. Maybe I did. Because now I'm not heading towards my target anymore, I'm heading further away from it. What's this say? Slow down, wildlife on road. Yeah, we're keeping the pedal down. Got 2 kilometers to go.
Yeah.
And as we've already worked out, 2 kilometers is a pretty big distance in this game. Okay, I'm hearing more waterfalls off to my right. Oh, no, that's not a waterfall, that's steep. Oh, it's a hot spring. Cool. Yeah, we won't look at that. You guys, when you get the game, you can check up the hot springs yourself. Get down this way. Oh, brother. Okay. I hope this doesn't drop me off the edge of the cliff. Because that's looking like what it's going to do. I'm heading down there. Oh boy. That's a fair way. Yeah, this doesn't have much of an engine brake. Whoa! Oh boy. Boy. Oh boy. Ah boy. Ah! Oh. Wow. I'm just gonna cut the corner. Probably a bad idea, but I did it anyway. Ah! Oh, oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Ah! Now, the quick way for me to get to my destination would be jump over there. Oh, look, I've got another destination. Cool. I'll have to come back because there'll be something I've got to pick up from here for credits, XP, and things, but I'll have to come back here. The quickest way for me to get to where I need to go would obviously be go there, hire a boat, drive across the river, but I'm not doing that. It would be quicker, but I'm not doing that. We're going to drive. That's what I said we're going to do. That's what we're doing. Alright. Now, feel free to pause at any time. Go grab yourself a drink, come back, and play the rest. This is no time-lapsey stuff here. This is all real time. I mean, if you want to make the video go quicker, just put it on times two. Times two, it'll look like I'm driving a Ferrari or something. That quick. Oh wow, look at this. I've never been out this way before. That kind of looks like it's a dam. Put down in the comment section below if you want me to come back and check out the dam. Well, I'm quickly here, guys and girls. I'm just going to grab this right here. Quickly do this. Report if I can. Come on, let me report it. It's going to make me get out. Report.
Hope you didn't get too close to any of them GPS stations. Them machines will make your brains run clean out the back of your skull, Buck.
He called me Buck, he didn't swear. Alright, I'm heading over that bridge. He called me Buck, he calls me Buckaroo. Just want to make that clear, so YouTube doesn't think that clean score.
Oh wow. You could park a plane in means you're far out in Ruby River Range. While you're there, drop by the outpost. Much like any other outpost, you'll be able to find notice boards, storage lockers, a boathouse, and a garage for easy access to transportation.
Thanks, Clayton. Now, as I said, I am going to have to come back here and look around at another time for XP points, discovery points, some missions that Clayton might want me to do. There's another station over there I should have gone and got, but I can do that another time. Now that I know it's there. Alright. Woohoo! I have no idea what that said, so... whatever that sign just said there, I'll have to watch my own video and pause the comments. But I think this is the ghost town. I think. Not sure, but I think. And there'll be things for me to discover over there as well. My destination's up there. Can I rock crawl my way up there? Let's see how we go. These jeeps generally tend to have all the off-road ability of a three-legged horse. So a bit of knowledge on off-roading will help you get these things to places they're not supposed to go. And this is going to make me look at the map when I get up to the top here and find this outpost. Because I didn't drive all the way over here for nothing. Alright, let's get out. Okay, now that has taken 26 minutes of driving. Oh, I gotta clean this while we're here.
If you cousins just go back, these things need to be monitored and continually grubbed some salt fuck. You think it was hardly worth it, so you see the damage they do. There's just a quarter left.
Means I've got a lot of those plants to find. okay, round the corner, and survey the land.
The locals felt that the regional economy would be unable to thrive if they could not mine Golden Ridge Reserve for its natural resources. They introduced numerous bills to Congress to remove the federal land use restrictions.
Alrighty, guys and girls, well, that pretty much brings up the end of this here video. If you like to give it a thumbs up, if you want to see more Call of the Wild Angler in a unique perspective, hit the subscribe button down below, and type in the comments what you want me to try and cover. That's not normally covered by every other gaming channel who's trying to do this stuff. Until next time, I will say thank you so much for joining me on this little adventure, and if you did skip to the end of the video, like most people do, you are not going to know the secret code word, so now you're going to have to go back and watch the whole thing again to find out when I said it. Ha! Alright, until then, I will say bye for now. See ya!